that wolf so he can fight it.
He took the wolf as a trophy. That's the story I heard.
Witness the wolf from the well!
Look at the size of this beautiful creature. Impressive, isn't it?
Clear eyes, strong haunches. It must come from powerful stock.
You fools. It could swallow the moon next month if it continues to grow like this. I know your mind, Javi, but this wolf is not your enemy. The signs of Ragnarok, when it comes, will be clear for all to see.
Tyr, you roll bones in a game you do not understand.
That may be, but I'll assume the risk. If there's a price to be paid, I'll pay it.
It's the Jotnar that trouble us now. Have you spoken with the Builder?
The Builder, yes. Is Freya nearby?
She's teaching Thor about organizing armies. A battle they're both losing.
Come along then. You must all hear what I have to say.
You spoke with the Builder. You saw his work.
I did.
And the sacred water. Was it put to use?
It was.
Your tongue is shorter than your temper today, Javi.
Indeed.
These markings are your warriors. Now here we have the four corners of...
Enough of this sorcery, woman! Just point me towards the enemy and I will handle them!
Javi, you look troubled.
The Builder gave me a demonstration of his magic. He conjured a shield that killed invaders on contact.
That would do well for us.
But your expression says otherwise.
I fear the price is too high.
What does he want?
You.
Me?
Does he take us for slavers? I will smash his skull till he shits out brains!
Now hold on, everyone. Let's weigh the...
Do not finish that thought. What was your reply?
I told him it was your choice alone.
You didn't refuse him outright?
For good reason. If the Builder believes he has a chance, he will continue his labors.
A dog will not keep working for the mere promise of a bone.
How about I beat on his liver till he builds us a wall for free?
Might we consider...
I will not barter with my body.
That would be a first.
Hold on. I've got it. The blunt end of my hammer on his family stones.
You are overthinking this, all of you. Give this Builder an impossible task, a deadline of, say, 9 days. When he forfeits, as he no doubt will, Freya remains free, and we may finish his work as intended.
He would be mad or stupid to agree.
You underestimate men of intellect, Lord of Storms. The Builder is a proud man. He won't back down from a challenge.
I do not like this.
Nor do I, but we must act. Loki, bring this offer to the Builder.
Your will is my deed, Runewriter.
You grapple with forces outside your control.
You were eager to see the deal done.
We're acid. She's vanished.
Watch out! Keep your distance!
The wolf! Shit!
Tyr, stand back! I'll get it!
Athens, flee!
No.
Wolf! Wolf!
Out of the way! The wolf is mine! Stand clear!
I will catch it.
Sharpen my axe with your teeth, beast!
Do not fight the beast! Leave it to me!
The size of that beast! A worthy hunt!
The final blow is mine.
Halt! You well-weaned wolf!
Hey!
Are you the wolf foretold? Are you my doom? Are you destined to destroy me?
I am the Death Walker. I am the living god. I cannot die. We'll see which is stronger, your fate or my will.
Are you the wolf? Are you my doom? Are you destined to destroy me?
I am the Death Walker. I am the living ghost. I cannot die. We will see which is stronger, your fate or my will.
Thank you.
you the wolf foretold? Are you my doom? Are you destined to destroy me?
I am the Death Walker. I am the living ghost. I cannot die. We will see which is stronger, your fate or mine.
Can compare to
while you were away, your Jómsvikingar helped to serve other Jarls. Here is the tribute they earned.
I would like to reorganize the crew. All right, bring out my lieutenant.
Thank you.
I have to go. See you soon. We must row in these waters.
Let's have a song.
Is there a sea skull
above here?
More sail!
In my youth, I remember hearing the story of Caridon, a fierce young woman whose father forbade her from swordplay and raids. Calda had skills to match or surpass any man in the clan. And so it was that her beloved Garpi asked her aboard his ship. Once again, Calda's father forbade her to leave, calling her soft and weak and fragile. But Calda ignored these insults and left. For a full spring, Calda and Garpi sailed the coast of Francia, raiding and plundering and taking much silver and riches. Then, in the early weeks of summer, a passing ship gave Calda the news that her mother had died suddenly. Calda was grief-stricken. Calda returned quickly home, only to find her mother there, alive and standing quietly beside her father. Calda was confused. Calda's father spoke with a sour voice. I sent the tale of your mother's death, for you were insolent. But now you are home, where you must stay. Hearing these words, Calda pulsed hot with rage. She slew her father and fled back to her ship, then set a swift sail for the horizon.
We need an epic tale.
You may not know this, but Ragnar Lothbrok once asked me to lead his early assault on England myself. This would have been 8, maybe 10 years back. It's hard to say. The winters blow into one another like a great white fog. But I remember as if it were yesterday. Ragnar appeared at my home unannounced. Naturally, I welcomed him. He had traveled a great distance only to see me. So I poured him ale and fed him bread, and listened as he talked. He was feeling anxious about his journey, leading so many men into such a great war. It was a burden he could not handle. It was then, with tears wetting his lids, that he said, "Dag, teach me the art of war. Lead us to England and to victory." But I shook my head. "Ragnar," I told him, "I have 2 weddings I must attend soon. Were it not for these, surely I would help you." Ragnar bowed his head. "Thank you, Dag," he said. "Though you will not be on my ship, you will be present in spirit. And that is enough."
Save it for later.
Thank you.
And up the sail! Who will share a tale?
Here's a tale to tickle your sides. Winter before, I was drinking in Stavanger with some companions. With us in the mead hall were men of Bard Jarl's clan, one of which was a poet named Halli, called Sarcastic Halli by most. Seven ale horns into his night, Halli stood upon his table and called across the room to another scald named Tjodolf. Tjodolf! I can compose a more beautiful poem with my belching than you could with your tongue and fine words. The room laughed. Tjodolf loudest of all. I accept your challenge, Sarcastic Halli. He shouted. Allow me to begin. Tjodolf then spoke this verse. Sad Halli drowns in horns of hubris, squeaking like a stoat. Yet proudly the pup calls it poetry. The room laughed again, with Halli joining in. Then, Halli tripped across the room and opened his mouth to speak his verse. From his throat erupted a jet of vomit into Tjodolf's face. His only composition that night, of which is he most proud.
Norwich, suffering hard times, I see.
Pull up here.
What's got into you?
If it isn't Eivor of the Raven Clan.
How do you know him?
I've heard all. Perhaps you can swing that wee axe on your belt.
I have nothing.
Eivor, back again. I've heard you're scared of flighting. Is that true?
Let me show you my
we'll see.
Here's the silver. Now begin.
To all those...
Then you're speaking to fools, and their knowledge is flawed.
Well, not bad. They say you're a coward who runs from a fight.
Whoever would say that certainly isn't right.
They're right. You are awful at this. So...
Then you've clearly misheard them, my wit.
Oh, you looked... Well, what a surprise!
Do not believe everything you hear, unless it...
Take the coin.
Long have I waited for the chance to serve one of such
worthy... Show me your valor in battle, and earn your place at the great table.
I'll take on all comers.
Shall we look or?
I have an iron stomach and a powerful thirst.
What? What's happening?
Finir?
Oh, no, not unless Halfdan sent you.
Let's pretend Halfdan did send me. Then we pretend you're Finir, his steward of East Anglia.
Right.
How do you expect to find a king for this kingdom, when this is the speed you work at?
I found him already, and as soon as he's married, we'll plunk his ass down on that throne.
Which man?
You know, stranger, you interrupted a beautiful dream. I was...
Dreams of death often run ahead of the real thing.
Oh! What business have you with the...
Danes from here attacked my clan. I want to know why, and how to make sure it never happened.
Ah, that would be Ruid's clan. They killed the last man I put here, Adelstan. I suspect they'll do the same to our next monarch.
A Dane who can't keep the Danes in line. Not much of a steward, are you?
If I knew how, I'd have rid our lands of them long ago. Ruid's clan plagues us all, Dane and Saxon alike.
You are the sorriest soldier I've met in this country.
He needs more than a kicking. If he wants to live longer than a season, he'll need the...
Who is he, your king?
Oswald of Elmenham. He was King Edmund's counsel before the invasions. And like it or not, he's the last Saxon noble with any sway.
Why not crown a Dane instead?
Halfdan Jarl made it clear. He wants a Saxon king married to a Dane, for a greater show of unity. But Oswald's not the sort of man you'd chase into battle with a grin. He's soft, and the settled Danes don't trust him.
Where is he now? I'll get the measure of him, see what I can do.
If you go, bud.
How's the water?
Zunin, guide me.
It wasn't...
I built myself a home here. Ruid's clan attacked us as well.
Oh, how nice to have a home to speak of, man. Mine was burned to the ground years ago. And by whom, I wonder?
Please, all of you, be we Dane or Saxon, we all want the same peace. With land to till and home to keep. Without fear of Ruid's violence.
Till they break the peace with another bleeding raid.
Nonsense. Their homes are here now. Same as ours, our futures run together.
So what are these Danes attacking?
When I'm king... when I am your king, I'll set things right.
You will be king when I'm a flying troll.
I'm Eivor of the Raven.
I am? You're not hit.
I'm not in the habit of killing kings. But I do like meeting them.
I am Oswald, yes. For as long as I can...
So what happened here, Oswald?
A clan, led by a Dane called Ruid, attacked this morning. They've been sacking farms and hamlets across East Anglia for some time now, growing more brazen by the day.
Do they know this is Halfdan's land?
They must. They just don't care.
Their chaos has touched my home as well, and I'm here to see that it doesn't happen again. Lately, I've come to learn that you are the hook that all hopes hang upon. As king, you could unite all the Saxons and friendly Danes.
A minor weight to bear, isn't it?
Who else, if not a king, should bear it?
Travel with me, Eivor. We can discuss my tenuous future on the road home.
What begs your attention in Elmenham?
Wedding preparations. Elmam is on guard as we ready my marriage to the Dane woman Valdis. She's a cousin of Halfdan's.
Good. A well-matched marriage can forge a strong alliance. So what's the holdup?
The holdup? I don't yet have permission to marry Valdis. Her brothers don't approve of me.
Slow down. Something is not quite right here.
Hold. A smoke ahead.
That's Beatley. It could be the same men who attacked at the walls of Norwich.
Stay here. I'll have a look.
I should be cautious around here.
Thank you.
I never knew you as a man given to verse.
Their little bodies, their little lives. They mean nothing to me. They're flies.
What happened here?
That should be the last of these pig-faced guards. Oswald will be relieved to know of this. Ruid's clan. They left none alive.
God rest their souls. I'm needed at home to make yet another fruitless attempt to impress my betrothed's family.
Show more grit than you're showing me now, and they may start to like you.
Yes, sorry, I'm just shaken. If you joined us at dinner, that might ease their minds a touch. Think about it. My doors are open to you.
I'd be happy to join you. Tell me when and where.
Wonderful. Visit us in Elmham whenever you have time.
It's worse here than I feared. This place is heavily guarded. A healthy seeming town. This Oswald has done well for himself.
Look there. A lone Dane. Can't trust that.
Shh. Be kind, yeah? As Christ would command.
Ah, it's Fazel yet. Or an end in a deck on
Heralds say the great Eivor seeks warriors to raid. Here I am.
Join your blade to mine. Let ring the sword song this day.
Oswald, where's this dinner you promised me?
Eivor, you came! Dinner will still be served, but I'm afraid you are too early. My intended and her family are not ready.
This intended of yours, Oswald, who is she? One of love or politics?
Her name is Valdis, and people don't marry for love these days, Eivor. This is an arrangement for East Anglia's benefit. She's from a Dane family whose military might is not to be trifled with, but her brothers, their motives are selfish. Why don't you have a look around and come back later? Dinner will not disappoint.
His bear shoulder bringer. Shoulder.
Hello and welcome. This could help you in your travels. This will be perfect for someone else. Always bring the strangest things. Happy to take this off your hands. Always good to pick up new stock for the shop. Always bring the strangest things. Nothing else? You have an eye for craftsmanship. Stronger already. This is the current fashion. All done.
I must take my leave. So long.
Lords, ladies, this is a day of peace and fraternity.
I asked you here to Elmenham to offer my thanks and extend my generosity. Finir, our steward. To our guests of honor, Brothir and Brodir. And to my lovely bride-to-be, Valdis.
You get to plow our sister because Halfdan commands it. But you won't drag us into bed with you, you hear?
Brodir,
the last Saxon king we backed wasn't half as mushy as you, and we lost 150 men protecting his maggoty arse.
Brodir!
If you're going to be rude, then I must ask you to leave. This is my home, and won't be insulted here.
Is that why you've come? To back this Thane who smells of goat shit and cheap pebbles?
I'm sorry, did you say something?
Do I bore you, Wolfkist?
I'm here to protect my clan. If that means helping your king secure his throne, well, so be it.
You'd be safer crowning the throne. It's made of less wood than, this one.
We'd all be safer if you had the stones to stand up to Ruid's clan. Between the pair of you, I can't see a single nugget.
You watch your tongue, Wolfkist, or you'll find it freed of your face!
So easily wounded by words. Imagine the ruin my axe would inflict on your flaccid ego.
My flaccid what? Please stop this!
You heard me.
That's it! She called us flaccid!
Limp, weak, soft!
That's enough fun for tonight.
If that's all you've got, it's little wonder East Anglia's in the state it is.
You are weak, sheepherder. Your Norse friend here can't change that. We are better off without a king.
Well, that's me done.
I think I prefer dream nonsense to these alehouse brawls.
What a waste of time and good mead. These brothers will never back me in my claim.
This dance is just beginning, Oswald. Get some rest. You'll need your energy.
And will I see you in the morning? We have much to discuss, I think.
I will find a place to lay my head.
And Eivor, if you can help me right this situation, you'll have a strong alliance.
Seems Oswald has set out for the day. I should have a word with him. Yeah.